Welcome to the ET-335 Altera Cyclone 2 FPGA starter board demonstration. Okay, here I'm showing a picture of our Altera starter board. It is made by Terasic, and here is our Altera Cyclone 2 FPGA. They were purchased by Intel, so the software you're going to see is labeled Intel. But this is our board. I've taken off the safety cover, the plexiglass cover. First thing we need to do is plug in our USB cord. And it's going to be B. And go ahead and hook that up to your PC. We don't need power. Everything's going to come through our USB, including programming. Here we have switch 1. We need to push that in order to start this board. Okay. And this switch needs to remain in run, even when we're programming. So I leave this in run. Okay, here I'm showing the very bottom of our Altera board. Okay, on this side, we have push buttons, key 0 through key 4. So when we do our OR gates, we're going to use these two switches right here, key 0 and key 1. These switches have pull-up resistors, which means when they're not pressed, it's going to be a high. So we're going to get a 1 there. When we press these, it's going to go low. That's why we're using bubbled inputs OR gates in order to simulate a normal OR gate. So these four here, normally high, and will go low when we touch it. Up here, we've got green LEDs. From LED G7 to LED G0. And over here we have red LEDs, LED R7 through R0. Okay, up here we have a 7-segment display module. We'll use it farther in the future, I think. So here we have switches. So we can make these high or low by moving the switches. And we're going to start here at switch 0 and switch 9. So we have to be careful when we program these to match the switches up and then make sure when we test the program we have the right switch. So that's pretty much all of our entries that we're going to use. Once we plug in our USB and we have power and we turn on our switch 1, we're going to get what I call the Knight Rider display. Probably youngsters won't remember that TV show, but his car always was flashing lights. So these lights are going to flash back and forth, and we're going to get a count on our 7-segment displays, and there'll be some power lights. So when it does that, that's good. Okay, I've opened up my Quarter software and our Graphics Lab 1 diagram of an OR gate, a bubbled input OR gate. So what we're going to do is, you should have compiled it. Let's go ahead and compile it again. And we should get no errors and a few warnings or no problem. Good. And you should have also taken care of our pin planner. So we should have all of our pins labeled and which direction they're going. Okay, so all of our switches and buttons on the board have been mapped to the Cordis or to the Cyclone, but we need to make sure that the programmer knows what that is. Okay, we're back to Cordis. So we have everything done. We've checked our pins, everything's ready to go. So we're going to program it. So there are two ways to program this. We could use the icon that's up on the top. It looks like things overheating or something. You could click on that, or you could go here to Tools and down to Programmer. Okay, so the first thing we do is we check and see if we have our file. It should self-populate, but if it doesn't, let's go ahead and delete it and go find it. So we're going to add file. We're going to go to where the folder is. Here we have our eAltera, but if it's on the desktop, we're going to go there and go in the proper folder. And we need to go to output files and we're going to grab the SOF file. That's the one we need for programming. Okay, and let's go to hardware setup, and I don't have my hardware is gone. And that's probably the way that yours is going to be on. So let's go ahead and show you how to repair that. Here I've taken something from the web on how to load our driver. But just in case, let's go ahead and just go through it. And I'm going to leave this as a Word document or PDF on the folders on Canvas. So anyway, so if we can't find our USB blaster driver, that's the one programmer that's built into our Cyclone boat. So we're going to plug the USB blaster into your PC, which means basically put the USB cable in it. Okay, open the device in printers, control panel devices. I prefer going to directly to devices, and I'll show you how to do that. Windows kinds of send us in a weird direction, but anyway, I'll show you both ways. And we're going to, if it's not there, it should be unspecified. And we should find the USB blaster, and we're going to right mouse click it, and then hardware tab, properties, and we're going to grab our new file, which I'm going to show you how to download. Okay, let's go do it for. Okay, we're going to go find our files again, make sure that you downloaded the proper one. So let's go to our Firefox, and I'm going to do a Cordis. Prime Light, mine came up already, but we're just going to look for Cordis USB. So we're going to go ahead and go to the Cordis download. Oh, we're right here. Okay, so we're going to get the Lite version. This may jump a few steps because I've been here before. SP1. Alrighty. And we should have downloaded the Cordis 2 software, otherwise we probably wouldn't got to where we're at now. So we need to download the Cyclone 2 driver devices. So let's do that. I agree. And I'm going to save this, save file. And let's go ahead, and it should be saved in our E or C Altera. And the best place to put it would be in the driver, Cordis drivers. That's where it should be. And I've already got it downloaded there, so I'm okay. And you could go ahead and put it on anywhere on that page. Good. Okay, so let's do our Cyclone board USB blaster driver install. So let's go over here to our window. Start, and then we're going to right click, and we're going to go to device manager, and mine may be already in here. Altera USB blaster. Okay, so let's double click on that, and we're going to go to driver, and we're going to go update. We're going to browse my computer, and it looks like he's already in the right place, but let's go to E. And and let's go to Altera SP1 Cordis, and let's go to USB driver, and let's see if we could find, let's see if that'll work. USB blaster, next, and yes, we have is Altera USB blaster. So yeah, as long as that driver file's there, it should work. Okay, let's assume we found our right drivers, and let's go ahead and do a program. So we're going to program it. Okay, so let's go to hardware setup, and our USB blaster is there. So we'll just go to USB blaster, close, and all we need to do is push start. And once we get 100% successful, we're going to push key 1, and we should get a red LED, and we should push key 0 and get a LED, and we push key 0 and key 1 at the same time, and we get an LED, just like a for real OR gate.